7 on your side has sent investigators to a number of schools. We worked with the full cooperation of the new Secretary of State, Jim Edgar, who has been in office only a month. The story our investigators gave was that they had problems getting licenses. They used excuses like they had no identification, their licenses were suspended, and they couldn't read. The school owners all said no problem.
He never even asked me if I could drive or if I could read. He never mentioned anything about that. It was just agreed that I would pay $200.
Did you ever have to take a written test?
No, because the deal was that for $180, I don't have to do anything but sign the papers.
I was in and out of motor vehicles in 15 minutes with a driver's license, and I don't drive.
These are some of the investigators who went undercover with me to a number of private driving schools in Chicago. What we found were schools that don't specialize in driving lessons, but do specialize in payoffs at the state driver's license centers. To get a license legally, you go through this entrance and first show 3 pieces of identification. But our investigators learned about the backdoor method, which leads to an organized system of payoffs and public corruption. No one asks for IDs here. The law requires an eye test and a written exam on the rules of the road. But with the backdoor method, our investigators got around all those tests.
I never even saw a written exam.
How did you get past that?
Well, on the application, he just put down that I had passed it.
The road test is the final checkpoint before you get a license. But if the right people are paid off, you can get a license even if you don't drive. We observed firsthand the payoffs between operators of a number of the city's driving schools and employees of the Secretary of State's office. It costs $8 to get a driver's license legally, but with the backdoor method, the price can run as high as $300. We learned that black market licenses are a big and profitable business in Chicago. Our investigators bought 7 licenses with the help of many people. Ruth Bernard of Tahina Driving School charged me $200 for a license under an assumed name. Pedro Vignettis from Mexico Driving School arranged for a phony license for another investigator, as did Alfonso Perdomo of CubaMex, Sergio Sandoval of Professional, Tony Guerrero of Azteca, and Manuel Delgado, the owner of Megi. In our investigation, we paid Delgado a lot of money for licenses, and he in turn paid his contacts at the Secretary of State's office a lot of money. During the course of our investigation, Delgado finally admitted to us that he pays anywhere from $1,000 to $3,000 a month to Secretary of State employees, who then take care of his special clients. He identified 60 people he personally has given payoffs, including David Greenfield, the director of the Elston facility. Francisco Medina, an examiner at the same facility, was also identified by a number of school owners as a key figure in the payoffs. It's estimated that he makes as much as $5,000 a week trafficking in illegal licenses. After 4 months of watching with our undercover cameras, we confronted him.
There's no money involved. Okay, man? I don't know what you're talking about.
You don't know what I'm talking about?
No, I don't.
But our pile of evidence is hard to ignore. Federal agencies recently staged late-night raids armed with search warrants for the schools we investigated. Agents seized documents like these applications for licenses that are supposed to be filled out at the Secretary of State's facility, not at the school. We found schools using these forms as holders for $10 and $20 bills to be passed to state employees when the applications are turned in. School owners were reluctant at first to talk to us, but finally several did, and they confirmed what we had uncovered.
If I was to take a student, an American student, the examiner would not expect $10 in the S-tray. But if I was to take a Latino, a Mexican mostly, they would want that $10 and maybe more.
You're paying for your services and we get you the driving license.
Without having to take the test.
Yes, right.
It is like going to a restaurant and leaving a tip at the table. It is as common as that.
A road test, everybody gives $5, $10, $15.
To every person who takes a road test. A number of the driving school operators told us that the payoffs and corruption have been routine for the last 10 years. They claim that it is so ingrained in the system that if they don't pay off, their students don't pass, even those who know how to drive. If you have any information about this corruption, we have a hotline number that you can call. The number is 346-9374. Again, the number is 346-9374. calls to our hotline will be kept confidential. All this week, we'll be showing you the corruption that we've been watching with our undercover cameras for 4 months. And tomorrow night at 10, you'll see me go undercover to buy a driver's license illegally.